This is Alex Merced from alexmercedcoder.com, and this is going to be video number 4, I think. Okay, so yeah, we did the setup, then we did server, then we did index and show. So like, yeah, no, this will be video number 6. Okay, in our build, and we're going to be doing the create route. Okay, so technically the new and create route. So the new route is going to be the route that takes us to a page to create a new to-do. So we need a link to that page. So let's head over to our index.liquid here. We should add a link. Actually, let's start building up that navbar now that I think about it. Okay. So let's head over to our layout. And then what I'm going to do is just kind of hit some enter a little bit here. And let's add these links to the navbar. Okay. And then the navbar is just going to have several divs. Okay, so far we'll just have one. Okay, actually let me set that up a little bit differently. A with a div inside of it. Okay, and the A tag will link us to the slash new page, and then this will be, say, like new to do. Okay, so far so good. And let's style that real quick. Okay, styles.css. So a nav tag will have a display of a flex box. Display flex. I want to give it a background color of, let's say, let's give it navy. And the font color will be white. Okay, and I want to justify items, or justify content. And I want it to do space around. Okay. Let's just do an npm run dev. Let's take a look at how this is looking so far. Okay, so you see there we have the nav bar, but that's, we gotta fix that link. So let's say a color. Actually, let's do it this way. Nav a color white. So I don't want to target all A tags because some of them might be in like on top of light colors. And then I also want to put some padding on this nav bar to make it look a little bit thicker. So 30 pixels padding, and I want it to have a bigger font. Font size 2 EMs. Okay, let's take a look how that's looking. I can probably do a little less padding, so let's do 15 pixels. Okay, that'll work for now. Not perfect, but it'll work. Let's just make that link kind of give it a hover. So we're going to say nav div. Okay, we're going to give it a transition effect. Transition color 0.2 seconds. And background color 0.2 seconds. Let's actually make it more like 3. And then we're going to make it when you hover over the div, nav div. Okay, the color becomes navy. So the font color becomes navy, and the background color becomes white. Okay, so let's see how that looks. Okay, here's why I gotta fix it. Oh, I didn't put hover over it. Hover, there we go. So that's now a hover effect. Let's refresh. There we go, and that's better. Okay, that's a nice little transition. Okay, let me get rid of that underline too, because that's going to bug me. Decoration, none. Okay. There we go. Okay, cool. Then when I highlight it, I get that. That's better. Okay, so again, this is going to take me to the new page. And actually, technically, that should take me to slash new to do. So go back to index. Let me just fix it. Actually, go back to layout. And this link here should be slash to do's slash new. Okay, so now we just need to make that new page. So I'm going to head back to my server.js. And let's make... Okay, so let's make... A route, actually, that would be inside our controller. Our controller to do. And we want to make all of our remaining routes above the show route. So it doesn't get, we don't end up having the show route being a match before the route we want to be matched, which can be an issue. So we'll make a new route. Again, renders page with create form. And we just do router.get. Slash new rec res, and basically all we really want to do is do a res out render and render to do slash new dot liquid. Okay, and we're not gonna send it any data. There's no really need for the new page. Okay, so that's pretty straightforward. Again, now I just create a new file to make that new.liquid. Okay, I'll copy the index one just to kind of get all this boilerplate in there. Okay, but again, I don't need, all I care about is the block, so I'll delete all that. And then what needs to be in here is a form. So we'll just say form. Okay, and inside the form there should be an input for the action. So input of type equals text. Then we have to add a name property. The name property should match whatever's in our schema. So just to kind of reiterate, in my models, when we created the to-do schema, see there's action and there's completed. So I need two inputs to cover both those properties. So in that case, and come to think of it, you know, every new to-do should just start out as false. So there's no real need for it, like a checkbox on this form. Input dot type name equals action. Okay, name equals action, placeholder, what do you need to do? Okay, so there's the input, then we need a submit button. That's type, it's actually technically input, type equals submit, and then the text on the button is the value prop, so value... create to do. Okay, so there we go. Now this form tag needs to have an action in it. That's going to be the URL it submits the request to. So that's going to be slash to do slash new, and then we need to give it a method, which is going to be post. And then this form is kind of set to go, but let's give it like an H3 and just say, you know, create a new to do. Okay, let's just try that out. So click on new to do, and there we go. What do you need to do? Okay, we can style that a little bit, make that look a little bit nicer. So let's head over to our styles. First thing I'm going to want to do, let's see here, did I wrap that in a div? So let's go back to that new. How did I do all that in there? Let's wrap this all in a div. Called form. Class equals form. This way it's inside of a block that I can just quickly move around. Okay, so I can just target that class of form, and what I want that to do is have a width of 40%. But again, always the thing you gotta be careful when you give like a small width is that a percentage can be really small on a small screen, so you wanna give it like a minimum width. Okay, minimum width, we'll say 300 pixels, because it's generally like on a small screen, that's what it's going to be. That should be min width. Okay, and which makes me wonder about over here, where I had something else with a minimum width here. Okay, and I'll give this a minimum width too. Minimum width 200%. Okay, thinking about just like looking at it on mobile phone, you know, we want to kind of prepare for those kind of things. So it's like 40% of the screen, but once you get to a smaller screen, it'll stop shrinking at 300 pixels. Okay, and then this I want centered, so margin auto. Okay, so let's see how that's looking. Okay, that didn't quite, it moved in there, but I'm gonna want a text align center. Like, that's gonna bug me if I don't. Okay, there we go. That looks a little bit more feng shui. Okay, so now we need to style the inputs. So I want to style, and the thing is, I'm going to want to style any other inputs that come up. So I'm just going to style inputs in general. So I'm going to style any input that has a type of text. Okay. And I want to say that any input with a type of text should have some padding. 10 pixels. It's going to have font size, a little bit bigger. Font size. 2 EMs. And then we're going to say that the color of the font is going to be white. Background color will be navy, just to stick, since we've been using navy and white a lot. And we'll get rid of the border. None. See how that's looking. Okay. That's kind of looking a little bit more aesthetic. Okay, well, now we just need to do that to the button. Okay. And actually, let's apply this to the button as well. The submit button. So we'll say input type equals submit. Because these particular styles could also apply to that. So if I do this, and there we go. Okay, so see, that form is looking nicer already. Okay, and I can type whatever. Now I just need to make what happens when you hit that submit button. Okay, so let's go make our create route. Go back to our controller, where we're gonna write out all our routes. And we're gonna say router.post, because it's a post request, to / todos. Actually, let me just make sure that's what we're doing. New.liquid. Yep, nope, that's not where it should be going. It should be just / todos. Okay, so let me go back to the controller, / todos. Okay, and then we do the rec res. Okay, technically, all I need to do is just make the data should be in the request body, because when we submit the form, that URL encoded middleware that we installed a while back, that's going to parse the body. So all I have to really do is just say, hey, todo.create, pass the rec.body. And then I just say, whoops, rec.body. And then I can just do a dot then and say, hey, you know, I don't really care about the new todo, but we do receive the new todo. I'm not going to use it for anything. And then just res.redirect them back to the main page of / todos. Okay, and now that should work. So let's see here. Let me refresh and say what I need to do, eat bread, create to do. And there it is, eat bread. It's been added. If I can click on it, it takes me to the show page. Very nice. So we have created our create a new route. Our app is coming along. Okay, I'll see you guys in the next video, where we'll do update and delete.